Hey everyone, before we get started today, I just want to say thanks very much for the warm reception on the last two videos. It really makes me feel like I'm spending my time well when I'm putting the work into these, so thanks very much for that. Today we're actually talking about two bowing techniques, soltanto and soltasto. Both of these are indications to reposition where on the string the bow is. So ponticello meaning on the bridge and soltasto meaning on the fingerboard. Okay, so we're gonna start with soltanto, the instruction to play on the bridge. So here's a normal place for me to place the bow when playing, around centered between the bridge and the fingerboard. And here's around where I'd move it if I saw a soltanto marking. As you can see, I'm not literally on the bridge because I still need to draw across the strings to actually get a pitch and not just vague noise. So here's a D scale with the bow literally on the bridge. Very little pitch, mostly just air sound, right? So here's where I would play a D scale by default if I saw the soltanto marking. As you can hear, it gives this really icy sound, and it's an incredible asset for orchestrators in certain contexts. It also brings a lot of the higher overtones to the forefront instead of just the fundamental pitch, which in my opinion emphasizes that kind of icy sound. There's also the same dynamic range that we have as when we're normally playing, which gives you a huge variety of colors. So I can play something quite soft. And the timbre is kind of fragile, kind of glassy. Then I can play something that's very loud. And that's kind of that more raw thunderbolt sort of sound that gets taken advantage of in what you'd think of as like a typical older horror movie, right? And you can get something that's in between, it's a little bit more moderate. And just for your reference, here's that kind of moderate sound across just all of the strings in first position. Just as I did last time, I'm going to be linking some score videos in the description so that you can hear this technique in other contexts as well. As far as notation goes, this is much simpler than the last two subjects. Simply mark in technique text, meaning above the staff and not italicized, sol pont. To cancel the technique, you can simply use the abbreviations ord, norm, or nat if you're a red-blooded American. Another way of canceling that I think I'm actually going to use in the future is sol ord. This is just because I frequently have things like sol pont, sol tasto, and non vib in my scores, and so it's not always clear what exactly is being canceled when I just write ord. It's just something to consider for the sake of clarity. Also, as one last note on notation, if you're frequently going between sol pont and normal bowing, it's also not uncommon to just use the abbreviation SP. It might still be good to clarify what you mean somewhere in a key at the beginning of your score, but this is something that's gradually becoming more standard. Soltasto is a more subtle technique popularized largely by French Impressionists. The indication from soltasto again is to play with the bow over the fingerboard. And I'm just gonna contrast that with like normal playing, so. Then here's the soltasto. And then again, here's the soltasto, just across all of the strings in first position. So contrary to Sol Pont, this technique brings out a lower set of overtones, and it has this kind of like warm velvety timbre, which makes it incredibly useful as a blending tool for orchestrators. Something to note is that as a performer, I've only ever seen this marking in context in which I'm meant to serve as a blending role or when the orchestra as a whole is playing very soft. This is largely because it's just more difficult and feels really unnatural to project when the bow is over the fingerboard, so great orchestrators like Ravel and Debussy, they know how to play to the strengths of the instruments and mark accordingly. And again, they'll both have links in the description. For notation, just write out sol tasto in full, or like before, if you're going to go the route of using the abbreviation SP to abbreviate sol pont, obviously ST would be the equivalent of that. And same deal when canceling, use ord or norm or nat, or perhaps sol ord if you'd like to be more clear. When you're doing score study, just remember that folks like Mahler, Boulanger, and Ravel, they're not going to be using Italian. So here are the French and German translations for both of those. If you've been following this series chronologically, this is technically the third episode I've released. I haven't really been making these in any particular order, but if you've seen those previous two videos, now would be a good time for you to start considering how you can use each of these elements in conjunction with one another. If you look at any Debussy or Ravel orchestral score, you'll see that the string writing is very detailed and employs a lot of techniques simultaneously to subtly nuance the sound world. Here, for instance, in the first of Debussy's three nocturnes for orchestra around rehearsal three, we can see that there are three different kinds of divisi going on. The cellos and basses are marked sur la touche, which is the French sol tasto, and although we can't see it on this page because the indication came earlier, they all have their mutes on. If this were to be written differently, there are also opportunities for harmonics, for tremolo, and of course the divisi factor allows the orchestrator to have multiple layers to this. So this is just one of many examples in these incredible French scores by Debussy, Ravel, Boulanger, where the string writing is quite nuanced, and this is honestly somewhat of a tame example, so please, please explore the links in the description. As always, if you have any further questions, feel free to ask in the comments, and feel free to make requests for topics you'd like to see covered as well. Drop a like if you found this video helpful, and consider subscribing if you haven't already. It helps the channel a lot. Thanks for watching.